Ooh, this shit I can fuck get over hungry.
More.
Hello there.
I'd like to know more about my family. I need to know what the cave is. Could you accompany me to see Lady Mirage? I'm afraid that without you, she will refuse to give me any information. All right, Vasco. Let's go see Lady Lorraine Mirage.
Oh, right then. Need more strength. More accuracy, huh? Oh, lady has a nice house.
Good day, Lady Mirage. Do you remember me?
Of course. Sir de Sade, isn't it? I hope that you and your cousin have regret to like it, yeah? But I have little reason to believe you have paid me a visit to exchange civilities. Can I be of service?
What can you tell me about New Serene?
It's a new city whose construction began not long ago. When I arrived 5 years ago, there was just a fort, a fence, and some huts here. The businesses, the barracks of the guard, the palace, and all of the houses sort of sprung up from the ground. To see how impressive it is today, even if it is still far from its majestic mother, is incredible. Of course, with such expanse and plenty of bandits, drunkards, and other lowlife have arrived. I'm very proud of you, in spite of everything. I hope that your cousin continues this way.
What do you know about this island?
Much less than I would like. The land is still wild and extremely rich. Its soils are full of minerals, some of which are unknown to us. With regard to the flora and fauna, you've probably seen how different the creatures and plants are here. The islanders protect their land fiercely and cannot begrudge them that. When you see what we have done with our own, glow. Such a source of richness attracts greed.
You seem interested in the islanders.
As a matter of fact, I find their culture fascinating, but I can't say I know much about them. They are quite secretive and protect their cult and traditions from the curiosity of strangers. I know that their sages, they call them Donegaga, are the guardians of their rituals as well as of the island. They have very strong links with nature and the creatures that inhabit it. They're also good healers. I could talk about them for hours, but you will learn more from the islanders themselves.
What can you tell me about the relations we have with other nations?
We play a difficult role, caught between these two enemy nations who are nonetheless our allies. The smallest action could tip the balance and draw us into their conflict. If I may offer some advice, be very careful. We do not want a war to break out here.
We would like to have some information regarding an important family, the Darcys.
Well, I could tell you many things about them, but I suppose you want to know something in particular?
Are there any members of this family?
Indeed, Bastian Darcy, the son of the family, has been in New Serene for some time. Last I heard about it, he was doing business, but that doesn't help him know in many years. The Darcys first attempted at establishing themselves on this island wasn't very fruitful. But I seem to recall that since then, the son has found a competent associate who's been working here for a long time.
Perfect. Could you tell us where to find her?
Of course. Ask for a Madame Clerc near the warehouses on the port. That's where she normally is. I hope the Darcys are not in trouble.
Don't worry, ma'am. Their name was simply mentioned in some business discussions. We are thinking about becoming associates. We would like to know more about them to form an opinion.
If you ask me, you should forget this idea, Your Excellency. Their son is a poor business partner.
Why do you say that?
I do not mean to speak ill of him. Perhaps it would be better for you to form your own opinion.
Well, thank you for your help.
Can I help you with any other matter?
My lady, I have to go. Goodbye.
So polite. Not bad for a game that was built by 40 people.
Can I help you? Are you here to do business?
Are you Madame Clerc? We would like to meet with your assistant, Mr. Dobson.
Bastian? I don't know where he is. I can't say that he often graces us with his presence.
You don't have the slightest idea where he is.
I am not his caretaker, you know.
You don't seem to hold him in high regard.
Listen, my relationship with my associate is no one else's concern. And if you didn't come to do business, well...
We must find him. This man you can see by my side is his brother.
Do not insult my intelligence. I know that the Darcys only have one son. Alas.
You can see the Nort tattoos on his face, can't you? And a merchant like you must surely know about the Nort's recruiting process.
So it is true. The Darcys gave away one of their children. Hard to believe. He was supposed to go to Hickney to deal with one of our clients. But I didn't receive any news from him after his departure. Given his tendency to get himself into impossible situations, I didn't try to get him.
Who is this called?
His name is Ferrat. You'll find him in the Alchemist District. I'll write this down.
You think something may have happened to him?
His mission wasn't very complicated. He had to pay for a valuable shipment and take charge of it. Bastian, if possible.
Thank you, madam.
Come, excited. Hobbs! What's your destination, my lord?
Just into town. I am an emissary of the congregation and I'm here to discuss matters with your governor.
Why the checkpoint? We've got orders to verify all comings and goings. The roads are becoming dangerous. Do you have anything particular to report?
Nothing out of the ordinary.
Well then, good travels, my lord.
Your names, titles, and business at hand. Sir de Sade, emissary of the Congregation of Merchants on Tir Fradin. I have come to present my regards to your governor.
Your papers seem to be here. Welcome to Hickman's, Your Excellency.
Jesus Christ, that's an expensive.
Thanks for your visit.
Huh.
Your Excellency, it is an honor to meet you. Allow me to present my sincerest regards in the name of the Congregation of Merchants.
And allow me to wish you and your cousin a warm welcome to the island, in the hopes that this visit will help prolong the profitable relations between our two nations.
Likewise. Nevertheless, another question brings me. The Malachor. The Prince d'Orsay hopes that these new shores will bring us new possibilities. Even a remedy.
It is an area that concerns us greatly, but be assured we are studying it acutely. Our doctors and alchemists are particularly interested in the flora of the isle. It's extremely varied and different from our own. In fact, we have sent a group of explorers into a very promising sector. Alas, we've had no news from them for quite some time now. We are hoping that nothing has happened. We would have sent a patrol to investigate, but we cruelly lack the means to do so. The natives have proven aggressive, even hostile to our studies, and have attacked us regularly. We are obligated to maintain all of our able-bodied men here in order to protect the city, but we would be happy to share with you the results of our research if...
Your Excellency!
This insolent interruption is untimely and unwelcome.
I deeply regret, Excellency, that one of our frontier posts has just suffered a brutal attack.
Report then and be precise.
The natives attacked us by surprise. Our men were massacred. Our frontier post is lost.
One more act of barbary. Dismissed, soldier. Where was I? Yes. We would be most pleased to share our discoveries with our allies if your cousin would send us a party to help us find our lost expedition. I could show you to which region they were sent.
I thank you for the information and will let them know.
If you are of a mind to accord me another request, I would be truly grateful.
I'm listening.
As you have not failed to observe, our troops, as well as our caravans, have been suffering incessant attacks. The merchants, including your own, are raided, often killed, and certain goods have become scarce. Captain Rainbow, who commands our outpost in the plains, has communicated his incapacity to protect them. Considering that certain of your own fellow countrymen are involved,
you would like me to lend a hand? I will see what I can do, Your Excellency.
Would you like to speak with me about any other subject?
And what of this conflict, Telenga and Teofredi?
Officially, we are at war. But we have never waged war openly here. Of course, we did not rejoice when they set up camp on the isle, and we expected the worst. But it seems that their only concern is to convert the natives into believing their ridiculous teachings. They represent no true danger to us. At least, not for the time being. And to be frank, we have plenty of other concerns that demand our attention.
Could you tell me a little about your city?
Hikmet is the oldest city on the island. We began construction of its first buildings 15 years ago, shortly after the discovery of the island. A magnificent city, where the great minds of the time were united in a common goal. Here you could find the best doctors, the greatest engineers, and the most eminent savants. In everyone's eyes, this island has great promise. And Hikmet is the city that allows us to make good on that promise.
I met Ula, the Bone Blower's clan chief, from the village of Vignama. He is an open-minded man who holds great expectations of exchanges with the colonies. He would like to meet you to discuss a treaty, even an alliance.
Ula, you said? I have never heard mention of this name, but to finally have an ally among the natives could only be beneficial. It is excellent news. Still, I fear that I cannot leave the city. That would be taking too much of a risk.
I doubt that Ulan will come to Hikmet. He is looking for an alliance, but he is not desperate. Such a gesture would be considered a sign of weakness by his clan.
That is understandable, I suppose. Do they grasp the concept of emissaries? Do you think that solution might work?
I think that might be possible. I'm sure he would understand that you could not come to see him in person for the same reason.
Excellent. Finally, some clear skies in our negotiations with the natives. My right-hand man will then go to this village to finalize an agreement with King Ulan.
I'll be there too, to make sure everything goes according to our plans. There is another matter concerning the same village that I would like to bring to your attention. A wandering merchant, a member of Ulan's clan, is being kept in your outpost. Can you authorize his entry into the city?
I see no harm in that. This merchant is certainly not a threat to us, and he might even prove useful if the negotiations with his clan should take a foul turn. Here, please be so kind as to give him this letter of passage. If he presents it to the guards, they will let him in and he'll be able to establish his stall in town.
I thank you. I hope to see you again. I have to go. Look forward to seeing you again.
Farewell, my lord.
Dungeon, I'm guessing.
If you come to do business, you should go upstairs. I am the poor animal.
Hello, sir. Is this the house of the man called Farak?
It is I. What can I do for you?
We're searching for Mr. Darcy. He was supposed to come here to do business.
Yes. Yes, he did come here, but I don't know where he is. To be honest, our exchange did not exactly go as planned. And if you are his associate, or a member of his family, know that you owe me a large sum of money.
How so?
Well, this Darcy fellow came here to take the shipment, and he was supposed to deliver me a promissory note.
Which never arrived, I imagine. How could you let him leave with your merchandise without payment?
Well, he's the son of a very well-known family. I did not deem it necessary to try and obtain more guarantees.
What if something happened to him?
Nothing happened. At least I don't think so. Why should that concern me? I'm not his brother. He owes me money, and I do not have the slightest idea of where he might be.
I suspect that you're not telling us about
him. Oh, come on. If you have not come to repay his debt, leave me alone so I can work in peace.
Business, head upstairs if there's any business left to do.
Why'd you say that?
They haven't been paying me, and I've had to work with cheap ingredients for weeks. Have you heard of a man called Bastian Darcy? It would be difficult not to. His name is the only thing my boss talks about. Apparently,
He did not pay for one of our shipments and still left with the goods. And now my boss makes me work twice as much to compensate for his losses. With ingredients I wouldn't even think to.
And what did your boss do?
Well, he spent every waking hour cursing his name. That's how I learned about it.
What do you do here exactly?
I create and prepare complex potions. Not simple health potions, but far more subtle things.
And if I'm not mistaken, things are not going the way you want them to.
The boss has always been difficult, but ever since he got ripped off, it has been a living hell. I work using leftovers thrown away by all the other alchemists, while listening to him screaming at me and everyone else all day. This is no way to live.
Bored.
How can a brilliant... I am certain that any... So why continue...
You're right. Anywhere is better than here. My boss did not only curse the name of it, he also hired some fun.
Interesting. I think we may need to have a few words.
If you could also tell him that I am resigning.
Solution was there. My shop will not survive this.
Tell us who these debt collectors are and we'll take care of it.
They loiter in an alleyway of ill repute, not far from here, in the science district.
It's my field. Probably a bunch of cutthroats. If Bastion survives...
If he survives, remind him of what he owes me.
Basic girl.
Get lost.
Maybe he's friends with the weakling.
Maybe.
In any case, it seems like he wants to share his fate.
You think I'm afraid? I've fought uglier people than him.
Vasco, let me try to take care of this. How much money are we talking about? You're here to collect a debt, right?
Between what he owes our client and our commission, it's a hefty sum. But if you want to pay any step, my lord, please do.
200.
I don't think you realize who you are dealing with, so let me introduce myself. My name is Desade. I am the legate of the congregation, and I am here to save the life of one of our citizens. If you do not deliver him to me immediately, I will have no choice but to inform the governor, and you'll end up rotting in jail in no time.
Damn it, that looks serious.
Yes, a bit too much. Listen, we don't want to get in trouble with the governor, so take him.
Yeah, if our client wants to get repaid, we'll have to make an official request. Come.
Thank you for your intervention. I thought these brutes would kill you.
Don't mention it. It's only natural.
But how did you end up in such a situation?
Oh, I'm certain someone like you, who belongs to high society, will understand. There is a game table here that is attended by the best of the aristocracy. I lost the money I owed to that merchant while playing. And since I got out with a few other debts, I had to leave the merchandise as repayment as well. But that's a mere trifle that my father would have paid for without thinking twice. I never would have thought that someone would send these types of brutes after me. What a lack of tact. In any case, I am extremely grateful to you. To whom do I have the honor of speaking?
My name is Captain Vassal. Nort and Seagill. It was a pleasure, sir. Desarde, can I do anything for you?
I'm asleep.
Yay.
one enters!
Hello, Captain.
Your Excellency, what can I do for you?
Governor Byrne has asked me to help you fight against the caravan attacks. Could you tell me precisely what's going on?
For weeks we have been harassed by the savages. They're waiting for groups of soldiers or caravans to be out of sight of the outpost and attack with incredible violence. They don't just steal goods or equipment. They kill without mercy. Only one man survived their last attack. He's here in a sorry state.
Do you think he could answer a few questions?
Yes, but take it easy on him.
I'll make sure I do. Hello. My name is Desardet. I'm the legate of the congregation. I was informed that your caravan was looted and that you were the sole survivor of the attack.
It's true, Your Excellency. It was awful. It was this. The violence.
We followed the recommended precautions to the letter, but it was useless.
You mentioned recommended precautions.
Yes. Since attacks occur often, we were given a number of precautions to avoid them. Do not travel at certain times. Do not camp near the road. Do not light any fires. All of it was useless. It would have been better to recruit guards to escort us.
What were you transporting?
Mostly food, but also herbs and other ingredients for scientists.
Did the attackers do it?
Everything was a blur. I don't know if he intended to steal or destroy it. Unfortunately, my companions died while trying to protect our carcass.
Are you saying that the looters started by attacking your cargo?
Yes, Your Excellency. Maybe more of us would have survived if we'd all fled.
Were there several attackers?
I counted five. Maybe six. But others were hiding in the woods. I'm sure of you. If they only had their usual stone weapons, They may have hoped to escape them, but their weapons were inflamed. I have never been so scared in my life.
How did the attack happen?
We traveled all day. We were exhausted. The night was approaching. We knew we were not very far from the outpost, but we couldn't go any further. So we camped away from the road, trying to stay out of sight. Alas, everything bad. That's when they struck, in the middle of the night.
Based on what you're saying, the attacks were very targeted. They must have a camp near the outpost to monitor the road.
What is their goal? Why attack all the caravans along this route?
They must want to cut off the supply lines to Hickman. We'll go to the scene of the attack. I might find something there to help track the travelers. The caravan was some distance from the road when it was attacked.
Please help me. Just keep walking, the Night Sir. This does not concern me.
Have mercy! They will kill me! I am but a merchant who wishes to trade with the big city.
I never thought I would see several Islander warriors attacking a mere merchant. And I thought honor and righteousness were of the utmost importance in your culture. I must have been mistaken.
What are you trying to say, Knights? Are you insulting us?
You're insulting yourselves by behaving this way. He's an unarmed man. He's trying to survive. What honor is there in attacking him?
He is a traitor. He deserves to be punished.
But you are right. He's not worth attacking.
Let's leave. His punishment will come once we have chased the Knights away. And he cannot sell his products.
Hablo reda odolmanawi. May the trees along your path always bear fruit.
Think nothing of it. Gulan told me that you were not able to enter the town.
It is true. The soldiers did not let me enter. They left me outside, and the Donaya Exdrakau took advantage of this opportunity to attack me.
Rest assured. I have obtained permission for you to enter from the governor of Hickman, which should allow you to set up your store in the city.
At Loreda, the Night Sir. Thanks again.
Farewell, merchant. Perhaps we will meet again. Stay alert. The crates are empty. Their entire contents have been destroyed. These goods were not meant to reach their destination. They must have died protecting their goods. Besides, these wounds appear to be caused by stone blades, the kind of weapons that Islanders use. Food has been destroyed. They clearly don't need it, which means that their camp should be close by. They acted quickly, methodically, and then left. Where are the bodies? Let's look around.
Help the Dalek!
Nani?
Here we are. Stay alert.
The food has been destroyed. They clearly don't need it, which means that their camp should be close by. They must have died protecting their goods. How sad. These wounds appear to be caused by stone blades. Kind of weapons that islanders use. The crates are empty. Their entire contents have been destroyed. These goods were not meant to reach their destination. They acted quickly, methodically, and then left. Where are the bodies? Let's look around.
Don't do it, sir. It's nasty. Move away.
was in the caravan. Whoever attacked him decided to drag him here and feed him to the wild beasts.
The Donaya Exegar do this as a sort of spear. This is a message for the merchants.
What the hell?
Feed him to the wild beasts.
The Donaya Exegar do this as a
Finally, here's the camp of the rebel natives.
Oh shit, $8.
Hello. Don't worry. I come in peace. I only wish to speak to your leader.
I am the leader of this camp, the Night Sir. And who might you be?
My name is Desarde. I'm the legate of the merchant congregation.
The congregation? Are those the Lugay Blau? The Yellow Eyes?
It's possible, yes. We live in the city south of the island.
That's right. We hold no grudge against your people. Talk. I'm listening.
I've come to speak to you about your attacks against all those who take the road to Hickman.
The Lurians only got what they deserve. They have captured many of our people. We must release them.
That's the price of war. If you fight, you risk men being taken prisoner.
I'm not talking about warriors, Renaixen, but villagers kidnapped in our villages. They mainly attack on Orimanawi. Those carrying the mark of the bond like you. They capture them, and we never see them again. We don't know what they are doing to them, but we are going to release them.
I see. But our merchants have no role in this. They are not warriors. So why kill them?
They brought food and weapons back to our enemies. We could not let them pass. If your merchants had fled, we would not have pursued them. But they resisted, so they do it. The city of Loyans is no longer to receive food or weapons. Nothing.
I share your anger against the Loyans, and I also hope to find our captured brothers. But the Renaixen also use floating houses to transport things. Your attacks were useless.
Listen, if what you told me is true, I fully understand why you're fighting. I'm even ready to help you clear up these disappearances. As long as you spare our merchants.
You no longer need to worry about it. That was our last attack. Our troops are ready. And soon we will make the Loyan pay for the harm it has brought upon us.
What are you talking about?
Soon, the Domea Exregar will march together, and we will free our brothers.
I'm sorry, Chief, but I cannot let you do that.
So you finish talking and...
You leave me no choice.
No, Manali. My mother is still held in this. I must do everything. So, will you come?
We will do everything we can. Let's go.
Okay, I'll get that one later. I gotta sleep.